the first time I had a full realization that biology and science were just amazing. My fifth grade teacher put on board, "What is life?" And I was just left with absolute sense of fascination and wonder. It seemed to me that that was probably the greatest question mankind could ever face or ever think about.
Susan Lindquist took to the lab in pursuit of this question. With molecules of protein in hand, she has brought forth a new wonder to biochemistry.
Audio tapes are this long, long tape, and you can have a symphony encoded on that long, long linear tape, this incredibly complex, rich stew of music. And so I say that the DNA is like that audio tape, but it's just a simple, long, linear string of information, and it has to be decoded in the cell by information systems in the cell to make proteins. And those proteins are really very complicated molecules. It starts out being rather nondescript and has to fold into something very, very complicated and specific. And you've got thousands of different types of these things being made, and they're all being made in an incredibly crowded environment. Cells keep things very, very tightly packed together because they get tremendous efficiency out of that. You can pass an electron from one protein to another. And so understanding how it should work and trying to intervene in preventing it from not working properly is a mission of my research. This is such a complicated process, and it goes wrong an awful lot of the time. And when it goes wrong, it causes a lot of really terrible diseases.
You've had a good appetite today?
I probably will.
Today, this biomedical innovator is working to harness molecular chaperone proteins. While misfolding often leads to diseases, these chaperones can help the proteins fold correctly and be used for beneficial purposes.
In the beginning days of my research, and actually what often happens with younger people in the laboratory even today, is that they get very disappointed about the surprises. They think that they've got it all figured out, and then they do the critical experiment to test their idea, and it turns out that it's not right. And that can be very discouraging, but actually, in my life, it's always been those surprises that have turned out to be the most interesting and exciting things.